Hi, welcome to the session on monitoring and reporting Azure AD B2C using Azure Monitor.
My name is Karen Schoen.
And I'm Razi Reis. We are program managers at Microsoft Identity Division. In this video, we will discuss the architecture of Azure Monitor, particularly focusing on the steps needed for it to consume logs from Azure AD B2C. There are a number of moving parts, so we will take a step-by-step approach to dive into each one of them.
Let's start by taking a moment to understand the logs produced by Azure AD B2C, which are sign-ins and audit logs. Sign-in logs give you an overlook of the interactive sign-ins from your users. That is, sign-ins where the user manually authenticates using their username and password. With this type of logs, you can get an insight into your users' sign-in patterns, the number of users that have authenticated in a week, the applications they are using, and more. On the other hand, audit logs give you the inside view into the activities done within your B2C tenant by the administrators of the tenant, like the provisioning of B2C resources and the administrator's activities happening in your tenant. Sign-ins and audit logs are retained inside Azure AD B2C for 7 days by default. However, you can retain this data for longer than the default retention by routing them to the Azure Monitor, as we will cover momentarily.
Thanks, Karen. Looking into Azure Monitor, it allows you to route Azure AD B2C sign-in and audit logs to various services in Azure. Azure Monitor uses Azure Storage to retain the logs for longer-term duration to meet organizational or governmental data retention policies. Login Analytics is used to create reports, which enables you to analyze and visualize the logs in various ways. Log Analytics can also be used to alert capabilities based on certain criteria defined through the custom queries. Additionally, you can stream the logs to event hubs. This approach enables third-party services to consume the logs and perform security information and event management, in short known as CM, related tasks. Now, you may have already noticed that Azure AD B2C, which is shown on the left, and Azure Monitor on the right, are two independent services. So, for them to work together, the Azure Delegated Resource Management is used, which is part of Azure Lighthouse. From an architecture standpoint, Azure AD B2C tenant act as the service provider. And the Azure subscription, where Azure Monitor instance reside, is going to be the customer of the service provider, essentially consuming the Azure AD B2C logs. All right. Let's go through the steps required to configure the Delegated Resource Management.
First, you begin by creating and choosing an existing resource group in the Azure Active Directory tenant that contains your Azure subscription. This resource group contains the Azure Monitor resources, including Azure Storage Account, Log Analytics Workspace, and Azure Event Hubs. You can use all the services or just one of them, depending on your needs.
Next, identify the Azure AD B2C tenant, which is going to provide logs to the Azure Monitor. Now, within this tenant, you either create or reuse a user group or a user. This user group or user will be assigned a contributor level permission on the resource group, which you have identified in the previous step, containing the Azure Monitor resources. To make the management easier, we recommend using a group, as this allows you to add or remove individual users to the group rather than assigning permissions directly to individual users. In the third step, you will perform the resource delegation by creating and deploying a Azure Resource Manager template, or ARM template in short. The detailed instructions about how to create and deploy this ARM template are available in the article provided within the description of this video. Essentially, ARM template includes information like Azure AD B2C tenant ID, resource group name, user or the group object ID, etc. Once you have the ARM template ready, you go ahead and deploy it as a subscription level deployment. Because this is a subscription level deployment, it cannot be initiated in the Azure portal, but instead you deploy it using Azure PowerShell module or through the Azure CLI.
Once the deployment is finished, you will go ahead and configure the diagnostic settings in Azure AD B2C tenant. Basically, you are configuring the destination for the Azure AD B2C logs, which is going to be the resource defined by the Azure Monitor. This can include Azure Storage, Log Analytics, and Event Hub. After you finish configuring the diagnostic settings, you might have to wait for up to 45 minutes or so before these logs become available within the Azure Monitor services. Congratulations! You have completed all the steps needed to consume Azure AD B2C logs in Azure Monitor. At this point, depending on your requirements, you can build reports, set alerts, and create dashboards using Azure Log Analytics. You might also use the logs using Azure Storage or use Event Hubs for streaming the logs. Please remember to check the documentation for the specific service to understand the costs associated with it. Services within the Azure Monitor are not included within the Azure AD B2C pricing and charged separately. We started this session by looking at the different types of logs available in Azure AD B2C and what type of information they contain.
Next, we discussed Azure Monitor, key architecture components, including Azure Storage, Azure Log Analytics, Azure Event Hubs, and their typical use cases when it comes to consuming the Azure AD B2C logs. Finally, we provided a walkthrough of the steps required to perform delegated resource management, which enables Azure Monitor to consume logs from Azure AD B2C.
Thanks. We hope you find this video useful and make sure to go through the resources provided as links in the video description.